Alright, DragonCon 2016! Woo! Are you guys ready for a very shiny panel? I know they set up all the rules and everything, you guys know what's up. There's microphones here, I think there's probably another microphone somewhere. Get ready for your questions. I'm Aaron Sagers. You may know me from the website Blaster.com, NBC Universal, and I'm very excited to bring these gentlemen out here for the Firefly panel. So DragonCon, let's get Harry, show your love, and without further ado, give it up for Adam Bartlett and Alan
everybody here appreciates it. Woo! I'm just elephant in the room anyway. In Serenity, when Wash died.
Yes.
It was, no. I'm sure it was.
It's been out for a really long time.
We can move past this, guys. So,
yeah. Oh, well.
Your question.
Of course, it was one of the big WTF moments in like film history for us. And we just, my question is, when did you find out, and when did everybody else find out that you were going to be the sacrificial lamb?
The second, there were two. Yeah, there were two. There was
the
one that took your guard down, and then the second one that caught you off guard.
Yeah.
Josh had called me, and we were talking on the phone, and he explained to me that Quash is dead, that it worked this way. If it didn't work this way in the script, it would have been bad. Wash's death raises the stakes in the last scene. So when Zoe gets cut, and
you're still doing fine, you're the one character who's like,
I got weapons. Yeah.
Jules' character, Kaylee, got hit by those darts, those poison darts. The doctor really gets hurt. Like, everybody's gets shot, so everybody's going down. And because Wash is gone, I've talked to a lot of people who say, oh my God, I thought he was just going to kill everyone. Even the captain wasn't doing so well. He had a screwdriver and the guy had a sword. It was nuts. It didn't look good. So, you know, I think it was he kills people. That's Joss's thing.
Yeah, Joss let us know in the very first dinner. Remember the first dinner we had at a very nice restaurant in Los Angeles? And he brought us all together. And at some point in the conversation, he reminded us that, none of your characters is the title of this show.
So who's up for dessert?
The
collective. So again, this is Saga. I don't know if anybody knows that comic that graphic novel. It's so good. These are just some action figures that Alana and Martha are working on.
Well, thank
you for your very uplifting question.
Hello, so my question actually isn't about Firefly.
Oh.
Alan, you're probably the most memorable part of Zootopia for me.
Oh, wow.
And it's like, oh my God, we were dying. We were in stitches. And so I wanted to know how Disney approached you about doing that. Or if you approached them, because that would be
cool. No, I have to say, they just said it. They asked me at a party.
It's
so
great. What's it like? I don't know.
People get together, it's fun, there's drinking, sometimes there's dancing. Ever since Wreck-It Ralph, where I put King Candy, they have asked it that I did Frozen with the Duke of West. I should do KK at least much. the Duke of Weaselton, they mentioned Zootopia. They said we want to do Duke Weaselton. Weaselton. And so, as a play on the Duke of Weaselton. So, but they put me in every movie since. I'm in Big Hero 6 and Moana coming out. I play Hey Hey. Who's a chicken? they started to make me feel like the next title I hear, it's just going to be like, so what are we doing? What are we doing? So they just mentioned it at a party. So here's a creepy iRobot t-shirt.
Hello there.
Hello. Mr. Tudyk, thank you so much for your comedy. You're hysterical. Mr. Baldwin, I have a question for you. I watched Firefly, and I hadn't watched Tusk at the time that I first met you, but I didn't realize that I could fall more in love with you as an actor, and you are absolutely adorable. So. What is your vocal warm up?
Yes, Adam, let me find the grunt.
Basically, just I channel my inner curmudgeon, I guess. My dad had a sigh that, we're getting feedback. Is that from that mic?
It's the double mic.
Oh, yeah, okay. I think it just, I'm channeling my dad. He raised three boys, and there was a lot of just disgust. I told my two older brothers, he had nicknames were, my oldest was Blunder. My middle son's nickname was Lurch. And I was Thud, because they were always body slamming. Practicing judo. So.
Is there going to be a Jason Isaacs Patriot panel with you, maybe?
Jason Isaacs. You know, yeah. Jason is great.
Yeah, you all should get together and talk about the Patriot. Yeah, that'd be a great panel to go to. Woo!
That's great. Very intimidating. I remember getting out of that first day and doing a scene with him. Like, oh my God, this guy's blowing me out of the water. Just stand taller, I guess. Move over. He's, yeah. No, I don't think so.
I don't think there's,
here's some shit. This is a call sheet from Con Man, the series, season 2, and it has like all the names of the people who were working this day. Tom O'Finkett from Blackboard. This is a good one. Anyway, just a call sheet for like this.
Don't put that on the internet.
Hi. Hi. First of all, it's an absolute honor to be talking to both of you. So I just wanted to know, based on your work in Firefly and Serenity, both on camera and your camaraderie with the entire cast, how has that played into your subsequent work and roles, including, Alan, your work in Rogue One, and Adam, your work on The Last Ship?
Hello. Rogue One, I flew a spaceship, and so I had some training.
What's this button do?
Not touch that button. Oh my God, crazy Adam just on that. So I did have that as an experience. You build on each experience, just like in life. Not just the work that you did, and definitely the work that you did. You hone your craft a little bit more, and it's great when you do a TV show. I found that you're able to quickly go, oh, that idea I had was a bad one. That was a good one. Whereas when you make films, it takes a whole year for it to come out, and you're kind of like, I kind of forgot what I was walking into the scene with, but God, it was a bad idea, probably. Working with Joss Whedon's words, and that, definitely, I feel like, elevated or help me for my next job, to take on the next job, the next job, the next job. They all build on one another. And then friends, it's not only that, we have friendships and things like that. And Nathan Fillion taught me a lot about leadership on that set, because he was a great leader. The main guy, the star, sets a tone, and his was great.
But that's true. And the camaraderie, the ensemble nature of J.K. Simmons at the Oscars when he gave his acceptance speech, he talked about being a supporting actor. And I think in our little family, all of us felt that way. There was no, and like Alan says, it rolled downhill from Joss, and although he was the boss of bosses, and if you crossed him, you're dead, but yeah. Part of a supporting player, and it's tough when there's one troublemaker for that troublemaker, because they're gone pretty quickly. And
yes, she was. Probably got Marina instead. Can you sign that thing? I'm gonna start just giving a tag along with. That's my name.
No, but what is this box saying?
Oh, it's here. It's a Bluetooth speaker. It's a Bluetooth speaker that I do voices for American Dad, and so they gave me that. I don't use it. Because I'm going to keep going on all these questions. Just I'm going to mention again and again, download Conman game, okay?
It's your new con manager. So how do you start?
So she comes in and says, yeah, it's I'm your new con manager, and then you gotta put this back and re-download it because there's issues. we just had an update yesterday, and I think that might be what it's about. You just downloaded it.
So we were talking about that backstage, before you showed up, and I think the burning question is, how do we get Nathan Fillion at our con and the con man?
There's a couple of ways you can hire him,
and
he'll come in, and 5 minutes. Also,
5 minutes.
His bus goes by the front, Karen, the helper, says, he's here, and you can run out and you touch his bus and you get him for free. Kevin Smith's character comes by security and he escorts him to his booth. It's a lot of fun. You build your own con and put in booths and you make money and then you just build it until you get to the Shaka Con. It's a lot of fun. Freema made it. They did such a good job. I think you're going to love it. It's free. It's on Apple, and you go to Google Play. Put in Con Man, and it'll come up, and you can download it and check it out.
All right.
We'll work on that.
All right.
Please remember, folks, that only works in the game, not in real life. Do not shoot soccer Nathan in his vehicles. Hi there, what's your question?
Hi, guys. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you all so much for coming. My only question is, what was y'all's favorite lines in the other Firefly or Serenity?
My favorite line in Firefly or Serenity. It kind of became something that people knew because it was in the trailer, but oh god, we're all gonna die. followed up very closely by, I believe I'll know you.
I was just watching on a plane. I downloaded a couple of episodes. And I watched the pilot episode and Out of Gas is another one I watched. And I particularly focused in on your introduction with the mustache.
Yeah!
I remember you. That's gotta be a mustache guy. You were so happy. Like, ooh.
You'd fit it and all of this stuff. And then on the day I was told, right before me, I couldn't wear it. I got word from the writers room, I couldn't wear it. I was like, put it off!
And they put it, and Ronnie Pipes, our makeup guy, you know, prosthetics and stuff, he just cuts and stuff, do all those, he put on the mustache right there.
You want to.
The director that day said, I'll back him. And then Tim Myer came from the office down to look at it.
What?
Yeah. And he went, I don't think it's okay, fine. And he has since apologized for second guessing. He loves it. And I don't mean to bring it back, but in comment again,
which you can download for free.
Now, also, we have a party tonight in the something room.
Nice.
At the Westin, we have a party. Just come by and say, hey, we'll hang out. My character wears a mustache. There is a guy who walks around with a brown coat on.
Yep.
You gotta find
he's
wearing a Hawaiian shirt. You have to find the friends. Yep. And actually get more experience points. This is a portable power charger, power seat. I think I got it at the con in sometime. It'll power your phone so you can play more Captain.
Okay. Which you can download for free on iTunes. I mean, actually, since you mentioned his mustache and his entrance, Alan, is there a moment from the show where you watch Adam, you're like, that scene right there, that guy.
When he's eating the damn apple. When's the escort?
The ambassador.
The ambassador.
Yes. Yes.
No one eats an apple like that.
That's not just a knife, that's my dad's switchblade. It has mother of pearl handle. Wow.
My dad's switchblade. You didn't bring your mom's brass knuckles? Did you mention that in the audition? They're like, he's got a tit.
Oh, rock guys love that. Thank you. That was great.
But it's harder to eat an apple on a switchblade than just to eat an apple. And it's so ridiculous.
I didn't like my hands being sticky.
you watch the pilot episode, and right, the pilot episode, yeah. Well, no, the first, it depends on which part. The train job, so the one that, anyway. Train job. And how funny your character is, you know, when you're like, I've drugged you, and he comes in and you're like, we tried to move him, it's just too heavy. You shoot the guy in the leg, and you know, what do you say?
I'll aim him for his head.
Jim
and Josh gave us license to break it. Be as crappy and as broad as you want, and we'll pull you back.
Yeah. Which is good for me.
The pulling back part of the broad part.
Not broad. So that wasn't just your
thing. I guess I need a lanyard. I don't know.
Well, this is not just any lanyard. This is a lanyard from Catman Season 1. This is a prop from Bacon. Bacon.
That's my favorite.
Bacon. We have this year. We have the Long Con and Shaka Con.
Hi. First of all, thank you for coming. Both of your characters were old enough to have been around during the Unification War when you were prepping for the show. Did you give any thought to what you were doing at that time, or which side of the war, whether in terms of fighting or just ideology, you sat prior to meeting the two red brown kids on the show?
I think Jane was just off on another planet. On the moon, already drinking.
Wash flew in the war, one sortie, he had one mission and he went down quickly, and was captured and spent the entire war in POW camps entertaining the soldiers with stories of the big battles. I was the person about shadow puppets and they got in that episode. And I was very happy about that. This is what you get download counting. What you get we shall call it this way.
And maybe Stella, I love you so much, and now this is yours.
Wow.
I wanted to say thank you both for coming, especially together, over here, right here. and I wanted to ask for both of you, Alan, for you, you play such diverse characters, you know, especially Dollhouse, for instance. Is that so? With Dollhouse? You go from being this seemingly crazy, kind of nice guy to alpha.
Right.
And on the other hand, with you, Adam, you are
the same. The steady letter around. That guy.
What I was gonna say, for instance, you know, you go, basically with Wiedenverse and Firefly Serenity to Castle to, Last Ship, do you feel like you're being
cast
and
cast. Cast. That's a living.
And how do you both prepare for those situations?
I would just like to express my admiration for Alan and what you said about his diversity of roles and his ability to do that. And your Juilliard experience was something that you expressed. And we had dinner a while back, and you talked about Juilliard a bit, and in particular was clown theory. And I always love your story about how you're able to embrace the inner clown and how you're able to be adaptable to each different situation through that training.
Yeah, it's like acting. Clowning is, it's the same as acting classes we took our first year. We didn't take those till our third year, the clowning. It was the same class, just done in this reversed way. But it was a lot about humor. The first class, our teacher, Christopher Bays, drew a line on the floor, like this foot, he's like, okay, right there. So we call them anger clowns. So I was like, one of the clothes I was thinking. I was like, okay, so you get up, get the line, walk one at a time, and stop at that end of the line, almost like it's a diving board, just say hello to the rest of the class and make them laugh. And if everybody doesn't laugh, you didn't do it right, go to the back line. And
I'm sorry.
What? And it is one of the best acting exercises because you have to strip down to just some honest place, because people come and they go, hello! And we're like, get out of here. They were freaking us out. And there's always one person in the end who had been through the line like 16 times, and they're like, if I had not become an actor, I would have gone mad. I really would have.
Did you see Baskets? You watch any of that?
It doesn't seem like my thing. I have such huge respect for it. It is like a religion to me. So here you go. This is a gift. This is something they gave me from Zootopia. I should have given some talk about Zootopia. This is like all this stuff, like City of Zootopia letter, and here we go. Welcome to Zootopia store-wide purchase at Target. Trader Doe's. they play off all of this. Jumbo's Cafe. That's in the thing. There's just a bunch of them. They don't exist, I guess, unless you were in them in it. So here it is. There you go.
Howdy. How are you?
Hi. I'm doing incredibly well. Thank you, Preston. This is my second comic.
Hi, Adam. My question is for you. What was your favorite part about working on Chuck? And I just also wanted to note you were my 6-year-old sister's favorite character on Chuck.
My favorite part on Firefly and Chuck was the family atmosphere we had. And we always felt like we were under the gun of cancellation. And so we all knew that we had to bring our best and have the most fun that we could, because if we were the little show that wasn't having fun, then they were like, well, that's just not fun. So we made them love us by loving each other. And I think it's really important when you go to work or auditioning or in anything in life, when you're going to a meeting or even at a party, is that if you're standing on a platform of love, that everything will unfold as it's supposed to from there, as opposed to fear. Fear is poison in
everything.
So I try to approach it from that angle. And Zach Levi, again, was the leader that Nathan was on Firefly. He set the tone. He was one of the most talented guys I've ever made, song and dance guy, as Alan is as well. So to have, and Nathan can say too. To have a guy, but to have a guy like that at the helm or the head of your department really helps everything roll down, and you just want to support that. And I consider my, you know, my character in that as a supporting guy, and I want to support the play as much as I can. And that was led by Zach and Yvonne. So I would grunt mostly at the other little minions that were sort of pushing Gomez around, because Casey's a bit of a bully. So. But a good part of the bully. He wants the best out of the people he's with, but he realizes that they're all complete failures. He's just trying to up there. Tell your sister I said hi.
Also, in comment series season 2, there is an actor from Chuck, which I won't tell you. You gotta watch.
I know who it is.
Downloading the game. Oh, that's a pass from Comic Con.
Oh, cool.
Before this gentleman asks, just his costume reminds me, like, this is the 50th anniversary of Star Trek, and I think it's a real... Who is your favorite captain and why? Malcolm Reynolds, perhaps, aside.
Mike Slattery.
Yeah! Yeah!
Were you a fan of Star Trek?
Yes, yeah. And I know Will Shatner. I've had the honor of meeting him a few times and been to his charity events. And he is a sweet curmudgeon. Just like me.
I've been just trying to remember the word she used. I came back with cuddly. She said you were endearing. What horrible.
Rhymes with.
Oh, I am terrible. I'm going to go with Bill Shatner as well. I just like him. Dodgeball. I just like he was a great captain. There was a little bit of cheese on it. At the time that it was out, and we put out those albums. And Dodgeball, that we were in makeup chairs next to each other. I was just, oh my God, it's him. And he said, on my way to work. The traffic was terrible. I had an 18-wheeler almost crash into me. Locked up its brakes. The brakes were screeching. The tires were smoking. It's like, oh, he talks like that. That's music. I have one of his albums.
He paints.
He paints. He's just. He's,
He's a red sandwich of horses.
I did a reading with him for Shakespeare. He goes, I said, well, what do you, what, he said, I pretty much spend most of my time these days, you know. It's a fighter plane? I wasn't kidding. It is a potential with him.
Blue Angels wouldn't have him before.
This is another PAX, but that was from PAX East when we were promoting Catman the game. Oh no, it wasn't. We were promoting it today.
Which you cannot download for free on
iTunes. Very nice
question.
Actually, I didn't have a purpose. So a couple of years ago, I came up and I saw you in a panel, Adam, where it was the preacher and the muscle, where you pointed out that Nathan was definitely the funniest one on the set. But as we all know, Kaylee, Wash is the funny one. So my question is, what were the practical jokes that you liked the best on set, either between each other, between the producers, or going outside?
When Fox said, you're going to have a Christmas party.
Nathan put your picture, got pictures from his parents and put them all over the set.
Those bad pictures, yeah. Where you're like in between growing and like this part of your face is growing.
It was like the nose pain ones, just the bad ones on the bottom of that set. I was like, why would you be me? Because I love you, pal.
They're pushing forward for extra questions, but I just want to say, I've been giving out these coins to all of the people whose costumes have inspired me during this con, and I just want to say, while your cosplay is a little bit on the weak side, your inspiration by far and away makes up for it, so I would like to give you gentlemen a gift.
So we are running down on time. We probably only have time for a couple more questions because we do have to clear the room after this. So, but we'll go through as many as possible. Just keep it nice and succinct. Hi.
So, Alan, I pretty much quote you on a weekly basis with "Cursor is nothing but a memorable betrayal." Anytime something goes wrong. And my question is, so you talk about how you work family on set. Did y'all immediately hit it off right away with everyone? Were there any fights? What were your favorite times together? And
we there were no fights. It was a lot of fun times together. We would always go over to Nathan's house, his old house in Kentura. Just go hang out.
Pool party.
But they weren't like, you know, the pool parties he has now. Yeah, sweet, sweet castle cat. Yeah. It was more just kind of like a little backyard pool party, you know? A little two-bedroom house.
His brother was there, very proud of the barbecue. He was still making great ribs and big dogs and burgers. Yeah.
And ghost time was good, playing Halo.
I remember watching you guys play Halo and think, you're experts. You're just really good at this game, and I would just end up shooting at the ground and the sky. Controllers. Control fault.
Hey, so this is a doll.
Get a close-up on that.
That's Wash. He's got blood on him. He's got that. There's a robot. This is something a fan made. I've had it for years, and now I'm passing it along because we're cleaning that room. I'm getting married, and casting. Thank you. Fantastic. removing some things, and I've had it for a
while. Hi, it's a pleasure. Alan, I wanted to talk about the dinosaurs.
Yes, yes.
Where did the dinosaurs come from? Was it you? Was it Joss? And sort of what did that do for your character development, if anything, or the writing, or?
It was something that hooked me on the script, because that was all there was on the script. When I first, I don't know when you were first introduced, it was there just signs? That's all I got, like 3-4 pages, the script wasn't written. Or if it probably was, it was just being held back. So that was my introduction and my interest in the project. It was definitely written. You know, everything was written on the, pretty much. There's, if any, very little improv or other lines, because I know I was asking for them all the time, and I'm always trying to get something in. And don't know. And on that project. So I remember with that, sometimes do not, and you said don't, and be corrected. Like, it is, you're saying it wrong. Not by Jocelyn, sorry.
Yeah, it needed to be word perfect, that's true.
Yeah, so this is a Serenity that was done in a 3D printer. This was in the writer's room of Con Man Season 2. Con Man Season 2! If you ever download Con Man the game, if you do, and tell me you did, I'll love you more. It just happens.
Cool.
Thank you.
One final point though on that, it needed to be word perfect, but there was a lot of leeway for action doings that we could improv. Like if we came up with a cool prop that would be integrated into the words that Joss and his team had put down, they were pretty open to that if it fit, because otherwise you're just two people standing there talking to each other.
You always had. You were really good with that. Watch this, if you rewatch it, watch his prop work.
Unfortunately, this is going to be our last question. Since she's at the mic, let's just get the question from her. Hi.
Howdy, thank you guys for coming. Could you guys do an impersonation of each other's characters?
Going to be for her.
Oh, okay.
Depending on the quality of your impersonation.
I might, kill them all. There's a god, which there's not.
Kill them all? Why would we want to do that? Can we just save them now? Tell the big guy to shut up. Where's that beautiful wife of mine?
It's uncanny. It's spot on. Guys, remember, Con Man the game, you can download it for free, but you can also head to the Con Man party this evening. Check that out. And also tune in to The Last Ship. And